We do some rounding activities.
Okay.
Okay, honestly, I can't even focus right now. I'm really hungry.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
Maybe we could order some food.
Breakfast. We have a Chick-fil-A flyer.
Oh, let's DoorDash some Chick-fil-A.
Okay,
let me look it up.
DoorDash.
Okay, I've got the menu.
Okay.
What do you guys want?
Spicy chicken sandwich meal.
Okay, spicy chicken sandwich. It says it's $4.90. So that's about
$3.
No.
Oh, okay.
$5. Yeah, that's about $5. Okay, $5. What do you want, Ms. Malphrus?
I'm gonna have a regular chicken sandwich. I've never tried the spicy.
Okay, it says the regular chicken sandwich is $4.55.
Chicken wrap with the spicy dressing and a Powerade meal, but the Powerade with it, the whole meal. It's the chicken wrap meal.
I didn't know that was an option.
Is it spicy?
Well, you get the spicy sauce.
Oh, there it is. Okay, that is $7.25.
Ooh, I don't have that kind of money. I only have $5.
Yeah, that's definitely too much. But it's about.
How much do you have?
I have $7.80.
That's all right. It's only about like $7.
What are you getting?
I think I'm gonna get chicken noodle soup because I don't have a lot of money.
Did you know that's a dance too?
What?
Can you show us?
Not right now.
Okay.
It's only $3.75, and I only have about $4.
Oh, what about one of those brownies?
Fudge brownies.
Those are so good.
You only have $5.
I'm gonna go get some change on.
Oh, I have those quarters from lunch.
Perfect! Ooh, okay, the brownie is $1.55.
Okay, so that's about $2.
$2. Yeah. We only need 8 quarters.
I have plenty of quarters.
Okay.
I gotta find some of my
money. I think we have about enough money.
Okay.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
I'm gonna order.
How long?
Is it here yet?
It says 30 minutes.
Oh, this is gonna be a long intro.
Today we're going to be learning how to estimate sums and differences using decimals. I'm going to start off by giving you an example, rounding to the nearest whole number and then adding. So the first example is going to be rounding. So this would be an addition problem. So let's say I was given the numbers 3 4/10, 2 78/100, and 4 19/100. So the first thing I'm going to do is round these to the nearest whole number, okay? So to round 3 4/10, we learned that if it is 4 or below, that the number stays the same. So if I rounded this, it would be 3. If I rounded 2 78/100, well, the 7 would determine whether the 2 stayed the same or went up. And because it's larger, 5 or larger, it will go up to 3. And then 4 19/100, we do know that the 1 determines whether the 4 stays the same or goes up, and it does go up. So we'll bring that to a 4. So now I can easily add by just rounding. Okay, so I'm going to add 3 + 3, which is 6, plus 4, which gives me 10. Okay, so now I'm going to show you another example. This time we are going to round to the nearest tenth. So we're going to round to the nearest. Okay, so my example is going to be 482 thousandths. So I'm going to write that down. 482 thousandths. And I'll also have 23 hundredths. And this time we're going to subtract. Okay. The first thing I'm going to do is I want to actually round this to the nearest tenth. And we remember that our nearest tenth is going to be this first number here. So if I'm rounding to the 10th, I need to look on this number, 482,000, so I need to look at the 100th spot to see if this rounds up or stays the same. And I do know that it's 5 or more, so this is going to make this turn into a 5. So I'm going to rewrite it over here. And this is now going to be 5/10. And then if I look at this, the 100th spot is a 3, so I know that that is lower than 5, and that means the 2 stays the same. And now I can easily subtract my numbers. Remember, I'm going to need to drop down my decimal, and then 5 minus 2 is obviously 3. So the key thing that you need to remember is what it's asking you to round to, okay? And I can easily estimate that the 482 thousandths is closest to 5/10, and 23 hundredths is closer to 2/10. So now I want you to try a practice problem and be ready to show your teacher tomorrow. And this one's going to be, I want you to round to the nearest hundredth. This one's going to be a little different. Round to the nearest hundredth. And this one is, and we'll add on this time. So 4 39 thousandths plus 1 265 thousandths. Be prepared to show your teacher tomorrow. Good luck.